Plain and simple. Let's sit on that Z.
Matthew 24, verse 32. Now learn a parable of the fig tree. When his branch is yet tender and putteth forth leaves, ye know that the summer is nigh. So likewise, ye, when ye shall see all these things, know it is near, even at the door. Meaning that the same way you can tell when a tree is about to bear forth fruit, man, that's a sign. It's the same way you can tell by the signs that's happening in the earth, man, the things that are taking place, the wars, rumors of wars, famine, inflation, so on and so forth, that the time of the Son of Man coming back to deliver his elect and to establish his kingdom upon the planet earth is near, man, even at the door, man, okay? Not two blocks down, not in another city, not on another planet, in another galaxy, okay, but it is at the door, man, okay? We're in the last days, man, the last age of Esau and the heathen's rulership, man. Okay, and the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom and shall possess the kingdom forever and ever, man. As it is written. Verse 34, verily I say unto you, this generation shall not pass till all these things be fulfilled.
Right, all these things, meaning all these prophecies within this Bible, man. This generation shall not pass. So it's roughly paraphrasing, it's going to happen during your lifetime. You're not going to die off and miss it. No, it's going to happen during this lifetime. Go ahead.
Heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall never pass away. But of that day and hour, knoweth no man, no, not the angels of heaven, but my Father only. But as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. Right, man. As the days of Noah were, so shall the coming of the Son of Man be, man. Okay, so the same way in the time of Noah, they was doing whatever they wanted to do. They was living it up. They was making mockery of Noah, man. That's exactly what's coming now these days, man. Okay? That's why 2 Peter's references the flood, man. That's why it references the flood right when it says, in the last days, scoffers shall come, man, walking after their own lust, because they was doing the same motherfucking goddamn thing back then, man. Okay, so now when the Most High brings that overflowing rain, which is the nuclear destruction on you fucking scoffing ass niggas, okay, y'all gonna be scoffing too, man. Y'all gonna be scoffing right all the way up until the point when World War III is declared and all shit and all hell breaks loose, man. Okay, that's what's gonna happen, okay, as it is written, man. And we about that, man. We want that to happen, man.
Right.
Okay,
and even before the nukes actually hit in that time of trouble. That's gonna be like when the rain started falling in the days of Noah. And these scoffers, these people who refuse this truth, they gonna look to and fro for this truth. There's gonna be a famine of the earth. Even before that, the nukes hit, these people gonna be looking for the truth, looking for the brothers, looking for that ark. You know what I'm saying?
And that famine gonna come well before shit hit the fan.
Right.
well before. Hey, what are you brothers?
Hey, tell bring her sisters.
Yeah, bring her sisters. Cousins.
Isaiah 4:1. Isaiah 4:1.
She's still in her
sisters.
Kamash, one of y'all brothers.
Yeah, but back on, hey, nothing new under the sun. They're like, you niggas scoff back then, and hey, came knocking on the, no, open the door, let him, nah, baby, it's too late.
Most I shut the door, man.
Right, even if I wanted to open it for my sister, I couldn't open it. It's too late, baby.
If I could say, that's fair, man. That is fair, because from the point, Just like the brother was saying earlier, when King Solomon came out of the ring, we kept going in and out of slavery. From that point on, man, Lord was giving us all type of chances to get right, man. Yeah. To the point, after y'all crucified his only begotten son, he still was giving y'all a chance, man.
Yeah.
So when, it's just like your dad, I tell you, do something. If you get to a point where you get home, and he sees it's not done, so he leaves again on purpose and comes back and it's still not done, gonna whoop your ass. Fuck that, man.
Right, because if he don't, what type of man would he be?
Yeah.
If he allow you, oh, okay, nah, you know, I told you to do this, you ain't do it. You know what I'm saying? I gave you a chance to repent and get yourself right, and you still don't do it, and I don't beat you out. What type of man would I be? That mean I ain't hold true to my word.
That's right. And on top of that, what type of child would he be raising, man? A fucking rebellious-ass, reprobate-ass jit, right, man.
Not only is the Most High going to beat that ass, he going to get rid of you, man. He's going to destroy you and bring you back through that righteous seed, man. Through that righteous bloodline, because you can't get it on this side. We see it every day. A nigga ain't going to understand this. Period. And that's why the Most High have us come out here with signs and stuff and have visions. I asked this man, you see yourself on? So, no, I don't see myself. I just see myself here.
What? You see yourself? I'm right here right now.
I'm right here right now. The fuck?
It's beautiful. The scriptures talk about, when the scriptures talk about disciplining a child, the scriptures say that child was rebellious, so to say, rough paraphrase, man. You bring him to the elders, man. You whoop his ass, you bring him to the elders. He act like that, man. Take him out the city, fucking stone his ass to death, man.
Right.
So
get rid of him.
So the Lord done. Brought you in front of all types of counselors. Y'all don't want to listen. Now it's time for him to stone y'all to death with nukes, man. Fuck that. Put y'all to death, man.
Brimstone.
You know?
Verse 38. For as in the days that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day that Noah entered into the ark.
Right, and that's what y'all doing, man. And that ark is the spiritual ark that we've entered into. And then there's going to be another physical manifestation of the ark, which is going to be the chariot. And you're going to be eating and drinking up until that day, man. Just like in the days of Noah. That's not out of our mouth. That's out of the scriptures. Go ahead.
And knew not until the flood came and took them all away.
Right, and that flood going to manifest, like the brother said, in that thermonuclear warfare, man. To be exact, 200 million nuclear missiles are going to hit America.
Right. That's right. 200 million intercontinental ballistic raindrops, okay, right, are going to pelt America into oblivion. Okay, that's
right.
What's going to happen.
Right. It will never be inhabited again. Right?
So shall the coming of the Son of Man be. Then shall two be in the field, and one shall be taken and another left.
Right, meaning salvation. You're going to have two working in the field. One shall be taken and one left, meaning called up. But you simple-ass Christians don't understand, meaning beamed up into the chariots of the Most High. One's going to be left here to be destroyed, and one's going to be taken up. Go ahead.
Two women shall be grinding at the mill. The one shall be taken and the other left.
Right, and that don't mean women having sex. Grinding means working at the mill, grinding mill. One shall be left, and one shall be taken. Go ahead.
The one shall be taken, and the other left. Watch therefore, for ye know not what hour the Lord doth come.
We don't know the hour, but we know the season. And we know that the Most High about to bring destruction on this place.
Right.
But as far as his Son returning in the chariots for our salvation and redemption, we have no idea. Our Lord and Savior don't even know what day that is. But like the brother brought out earlier, keep your garments, because if you get found naked, meaning without the understanding of these scriptures, you're going to be the one that's left. Plain and simple. Go ahead, up.
This is Habakkuk 2:3. For the vision is set for appointed time.
Right, appointed, meaning the Most High has already appointed what time this is going to take place. So you decide that, oh, I want to go to college, I want to do this, I want to. No, that doesn't coincide with what the Most High has appointed. That's what you people have to understand. Go ahead.
But at the end, it shall speak and not lie.
Right, and it's speaking. How? Mainly through his prophets and the prophecies that's unfolding. It's speaking and it shall not lie. But it's speaking to the men of the Lord, the watchers, the seers. That's who it's speaking to. It ain't speaking to these coons walking up and down the street. Go ahead.
Though it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come. It will not tarry.
Right, and like the brother brought out in 2 Peter, you know, they saying that it was for a appointed time and it still hasn't happened. No, the scripture's telling the men of the Lord, wait for it. Keep your garments, keep the faith. It's coming, and we see it. We see it vividly that it's about to happen. Go ahead, keep going.
Behold, his soul, which is lifted up, it's not upright in him.
Right, that's talking about the so-called white man who's going to come with that flood. Go ahead.
but the just shall live by his faith.
Right, and the just are the Israelites, man. We're going to live by faith that amidst all that destruction and turmoil, our power is going to deliver us from it. That's all we got to hang our hat on. Go ahead.
Yea, also, because he transgresseth by wine.
Wine, meaning philosophies and doctrines. Go ahead.
He is a proud man.
Right, the so-called white man is a proud man. He actually believes that he's going to defeat the Most High. He don't get no prouder than that, man. Go ahead.
Neither keepeth at home.
Go ahead.
Who enlargeth his desire as hell, and is as death, and cannot be satisfied.
Right, the so-called white man is not satisfied. Right. He owns the whole entire globe. He owns space. He got space stations up there, man. But he's still not satisfied. And what's proof of that? He wants every one of these people walking up and down the street to have an RFID chip put in.
That's right.
Go ahead.
But gathereth unto him our nations, and heapeth unto him our people.
Right, and that, America is a perfect exemplification of that. Because here in America, you have every kindred and tongue, every nation of people living here in America, showing you that the so-called white man heapeth to himself all people. Go ahead.
Shall not all these take up a parable against him, and a tainted proverb against him, and say, woe to him that increaseth that which is not his.
Right, and that's what the white man has done. He's going around raping, pillaging, and robbing all the nations of the earth, all the lands of the earth. Why? Because it's going back into his blessing, which is spoke of in Genesis. But you have to use common sense about it. Soon, those people are going to say, you know what? We're sick of this motherfucker, man. And everybody, all nations of people, are sick of the so-called white man, except you niggas on this side, man. That's why you're going to be thrust through, because you joined unto him. Go ahead.
How long? And to him that ladeth himself with thick clay.
Ladeth himself with thick clay, meaning debt.
That's right.
And hey, we already know about America's debt, man. That goes without saying.
$19 trillion.
And that's just the interest.
Yep.
Benjamin Simon.
What?
Simon, Zebulon, Ephraim, Gad, Reuben. What is all these names?
You see yourself on the sign?
Puerto Rican? Yeah, I'm Puerto Rican Italian.
Oh yeah, what's your dad?
My dad's a Black American Italian, Puerto Rican.
Well, we come out to tell our people, the Israelites, their true nationality, and to come back into the law, statutes, and commandments. And if you don't flip the sign up, if you don't get back to your law, statutes, and commandments, and your nationality...
Be destroyed by fire?
Yeah!
Get out of here!
Yeah, right. Man. Right, clap it up for us. Clap it up.
Hell no!
Yeah.
This is the devil. This image is not biblical. That's Jesus! That's not the devil! Okay, Jesus could be a Negro, I'm down with that, but why do you say he's a devil? But why is he a devil? That's the Son of God, man!
What you need to understand is that that picture is depicting a false image of who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ. So therefore, we call that image an image of the devil because it is not biblical. You understand?
No.
Nice.
I don't. I've been brought up as a Christian, and Jesus is the Son of God.
You see, that's why Esau got to die, because we were just talking about how they steal everything from everybody. They even stole our heritage.
That's right.
And they took the image of the Most High Son and put this bullshit to where people die by it.
Yep.
They'll die by it, and it's bullshit where you can look it up. Yep. It ain't like we just got the sign just for to grab people's attention. We got scriptures there so they can look it up and
but
see.
But he's not a devil.
Esau is the devil. The so-called white man is Esau. The so-called white man is the devil, and he's going to burn.
That's right.
That's right.
He's the devil. The devil is not somebody underground with a pitchfork. The so-called white man is the devil.
Jesus is not a devil.
You know what the word devil mean, man? What the word devil
not
mean?
A scorner.
So how you gonna say he's not a devil?
He's not.
You don't even know what the word means.
A how devil you say is he's a, not demon, a demon.
No, it's not, man.
Yes,
it's a
he
deceiver,
is.
Man. Yeah. You know who that is?
But he's not a demon,
though. Do you know who this is?
You got horns on
you. You know who is this?
That's supposed to be Jesus.
No, that is Cesare Borgia, man. The son of Pope Alexander VI of Rome. That is not who the world called Jesus Christ.
You don't know history. That motherfucker's dumb, man.
You gotta be kidding, bro.
You don't know history, man.
I don't know history. I know the Bible.
You don't know the Bible.
You got a good one, man. Go down there and
pray. You gotta name these two. Toothless Tim and comes to camp.
He don't know his
name. No, but y'all got it wrong. He's not a devil.
Yo, this is what you call public school teachings, man. An example of public school teachings.
He's not a devil. I don't know why you got him as a devil.
This is 1 Maccabees 3:48. And laid open the book of the law wherein the heathen has sought to paint the likeness of their images.
Yeah, that's what Esau did. That's what the so-called white man did. That's what, like the brothers just said, Pope Alexander sought to do.
But I'm not he got, all
he got,
not all
Michelangelo, Leonardo da Vinci, to get sit down, Cesare Borgia, and paint that image. Not only that image, they repaint the images of the prophets. They repaint the images of David. They repaint the images of Israel, Israelites. That's what he did. That's what he accomplished. Like the scriptures say, the devil deceived the whole world. That means...
Wait a minute.
By the whole world, that means you, your mama, your grandma, your auntie, your uncle.
Wait a minute.
The devil deceived the whole world with them images.
Ethiopia, okay, Ethiopia, all right? Is in
24. The earth is given into the hand of the wicked. He covers the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he?
If not, where and who is he? Who did that shit? Like for real. He covered the faces of the other judges, of the powers, of Yahweh, why Yahweh shot, of the prophets. So we wouldn't have anything to look at and have a self confidence that we the children of the Most High. But he painted those images so we could see the white man as God.
Okay. And so
if not, the so-called white man, who is he?
Wait a minute. You got Africa on there, right?
Right here.
You got Africa in there.
Hey, man.
Right?
Hey, go down there and preach, man.
Yeah, man. You got
Africa is a European country.
Yeah,
okay?
That's why we can't wait for this shit to be
that's
over
where
with.
All the
this motherfucker people, idiotic, but he... Gonna
and
stand
the Israelites,
there and he gonna come
born.
Against this.
This is Isaiah 13:1. The burden of Babylon, which Isaiah the son of Amos did see.
Yeah, it's a burden that's finna come upon this place, man. It's gonna be real heavy upon America, man. This shit too sweet out here for these people, man. Be ready for this shit to be over with, man. This is so much fucking foolishness
devil,
and wickedness out here. So the Lord got a burden for Babylon, for America.
Lift ye up a banner upon the high mountain, exalt the voice unto them, shake the hand that they may go into the gates of the nobles.
We out here to edify, Lord willing, edify any member of the elect, but also we out here to condemn this fucking place. And let them know that destruction is coming, that fire gotta burn this place up, and it will happen.
I have commanded my sanctified ones, I have also called my mighty ones for my anger, even them that rejoice in my highness. I'm gonna drop it to 17. Behold, I will stir up the means against them, which shall not regard silver, and as for gold, they shall not delight in it.
Yeah, Russia's gonna come against this bitch. Russia gonna come against this bitch. Russia a bad motherfucker right now. America ain't the bad one right now. Russia bad. They about to have troops over here. They about to send nukes over here and all of that. They stirring up this World War III. The Lord is stirring up this shit because America got to fall down just like ancient Babylon did, just like Persia did, just like ancient Rome did, and just like ancient Assyria did, and so forth and so on. America got to fall too.
Can I bring up a news article real quickly. All right. One of the brothers that this just came out 3 days ago. It said Russia simulated a nuclear strike against Sweden, NATO admits. So just to add that, yo, this year the Russian Air Force conducted a mock nuclear strike against Sweden during war games less than 3 years ago. So they've been getting ready for nuclear war. Just to edify that.
Yeah, Russia ain't playing no games. They on some strong arm shit, and that's the Lord putting the spirit on them.
This is Ezekiel 38 verse 4. And I will turn thee back and put hooks into thy jaws. And I will bring thee forth and all thine armies, horses and horsemen.
Yeah, and that scripture is talking about Gog, which is Russia, said they're gonna turn them back, because you had the USSR, they was a strong force. But then after the Cold War, they really dissolved. But the Lord is turning them back and giving them all these weapons and giving them all this power.
Verse 18, their bows also shall dash the young men to pieces.
Yeah, and that's with martial law with them troops, and ultimately when they send them nukes over here.
And they shall have no pity upon on the fruit of the womb. Their eyes shall not spare children. In Babylon, the glory of kingdoms, the beauty of the Chaldeans' excellency shall be as when Yahweh Bashim Yahshai overthrew Sodom and Gomorrah. Man.
Right. And they know it. They've been, that scripture been in there for over 2,000 years, about 3,000 years. That's not something new. So they make laws where gays can marry and shit. The Lord said he gonna do this place as Sodom and Gomorrah. They gonna be acting like Sodom and Gomorrah, and he gonna burn them up in the same manner.
Say this out, and they have declared their sin as Sodom and Gomorrah. Mm-hmm. They done declared it.
The scriptures say they should have no pity. Pity for what? Them Russians over there, man, they like tough, man. They tough. And these people over here, straight up faggots, man. All these people are faggots and homosexuals. Out of their yard, they down with it. They believe that everybody should have a choice. This shit ain't gonna be all pretty real soon, though. Shit ain't gonna be all love real soon.
Verse 20, and it shall never be inhabited, neither shall it be dwelt from generation to generations, neither shall Arabian pitch tent there, neither shall the shepherds make their fold there.
Yeah, ain't gonna be them fucking Ishmaelites coming over here, pitching tent with all these stores and shit. The future of America is nothing. It's desolation.
That shit like that, going into that Ishmaelite shit, that shit big business. And that's why, because you just use Miami, you know, as an example. I want to say 70s, early 80s, most of these corner stores was black owned. But what happened is the Ishmaelites, they formed a franchise, Ishmael, yeah, to where they get goods, you know, everybody put their money together and they get goods at a discounted price. So that outsourced all these other monks. Cause if you look, all these stores owned by Ishmael. The Ishmaelites running all this shit. Why? That go back to Psalms 83. Psalms 83 and 1. They confederate against us, man. And they actually have a confederation, cause Ishmaelite was breaking that shit down to me. They all, cause you'll see an Ishmaelite working at this store, and then a month later he'll be working at this other store. Cause they got a franchise, a ring, where they actually, spend money and get goods at a discounted price together. That's how that shit works.
Yeah. Instead of having a restaurant with Jake, or so-called black, being a black-owned restaurant in the hood, you got a Chinese restaurant in the hood. They fucking selling you fucking slime and rats and shit.
Dog-head soup.
You know, it's a tumult against these people on this sign right here. Go ahead. But it's all gonna be over real soon.